With Minecraft Snapshot 23w31a, the resource pack version is now 16, which comes with some rather huge changes. My name is Sliced Lime, and I'm here to tell you all about it. Let's start with the pack format itself. Both resource and data packs now support multi-version packs. This allows you to create packs that are compatible with multiple versions of the game, starting with this one. This is done by including a supported formats field, which lists all supported pack versions. Packs can also contain overlay directories, which are sub-pack folder structures that are applied on top of the base pack, but only for certain version ranges. That means you can have a shared base for all supported versions of the pack, but separate files where needed. An overlay can replace or add files, but not remove files from the base pack. These overlays are added in a new overlay section in the pack metadata. The main thing that has happened in this version is that all textures that contain multiple sprites in the same sheet for the user interface have been split into separate image files. These can now be found in a new folder called Textures GUI Sprites. In addition, the villager2.png file is now called villager.png, and the icon/trial-available and realm-status/expire-soon animations are now done using .mc meta files. All of those changes can be made to your packs automatically using a tool provided by Mojang called Slicer. If that seems familiar and you've been around all the way back to Minecraft 1.14, you might have seen a previous version of this tool as well. Running this version of the tool requires a Java 17 installation, and running it will only affect the GUI textures folders of your packs. Slicer doesn't change your files, instead it will output the result of converting the files into a new folder. It takes three arguments. First, the input, which is your pack directory or zip. Then the output directory, and finally an optional argument for a leftover directory. If you specify that, it will be filled with copies of the source images from your pack, with added highlights for areas that were migrated. Everything outside those areas is not needed for the vanilla game. This means that from this point on, any sprite can now be animated using a .mc meta file, similar to other atlases. Sprites in the GUI Atlas can also configure their scaling behavior in a new GUI section in the MC meta format. That section has a scaling field, which has a type. The type is one of stretch, which is the default, tile, and 9slice. When the type is tile, the scaling data also has width and height fields describing the repetition of the texture. When the type is 9slice, the sprite is split into 4 corners, 4 edges, and 1 center slice, which will tile across the available space. In this case, the data also has width and height, which is the number of pixels to cover on screen across its width. It also has a border field, which determines how the slices are made. This can either be a single constant, in which case it specifies a uniform border width. It can also be an object with 4 fields called top, left, right, and bottom. In addition to that, some other smaller changes have also been made. The bundle tooltip background is now drawn as a 9-sliced sprite. The icons for the accessibility, language, and realms news buttons have been split from their underlying button texture, and the realms invite button is now drawn as an overlay on the normal button texture as well. And in text news, the smithing template item translation keys are now separate, so each smithing template type has its own key. And that's all for Resource Pack version 16. Thank you for watching, my name is Sliced Lime, and I'll see you next time.